Hi there, you're in the lab with your mate JJ. Today is unboxing day. In the unboxing segments of the show, we take a look at a new piece of equipment that's just coming fresh out of its box. So today I've got a big honking computer just here. I'll put you on the other camera in a second and you'll be able to see. But before I do that, I thought I might show you the specs. So let's jump over to the computer together. Now, here we are on the computer, and this is my computer's wiki page. And I've got a new computer here called Treat, which is going to be my Windows 11 gaming rig. So I thought I'd just show you the specs quickly. This, I ordered it from Amazon. And it's the MSI Mag Infinite S3 14NUC7-1456AU Enthusiast Gaming Desktop. Comes with a 3-year warranty, and I paid about 1900 Aussie dollary dues for this one. It came with an Intel Core i7-14700F CPU, and I'll give you some more specs on that in a minute. And it came with the RTX 4060 8GB NVIDIA GPU, and I'll give you some specs on that as well. It comes with 18GB of DDR5 RAM, but I'm going to be taking 32GB out of my other workstation, Charisma, which is being upgraded. So this is going to end up with 32 gigabytes to replace the 16 that it comes with, but I won't be installing that today because that RAM hasn't come out of the old computer yet. I'm waiting for some stuff to arrive. This came with a 1 terabyte M2 SSD, and it came with a 2 terabyte spinning rust hard drive. It's got Wi-Fi, it's got Bluetooth, and it comes with Windows 11 Home, which is all I need for the gaming. So all up, I paid about 2,400 Australian dollary dues, if you count the extra bits that I paid for. I should mention, I got a couple of RCA cables. These are just audio cables to connect up to the 5.1 surround sound. And I got this power button. I'll show you that quickly as well. So the power button's just an external power button for the computer, so I can keep it up on the desk here. And I'm going to install this computer underneath my workstation here at the back, so I won't have ready access to the power button, which is why I got this. So it's just a remote power switch. So there you go. Might as well have a look at the graphics card. So this is the 4060 family. I'm not sure if there's any specs or anything interesting here. My one came with 8GB of RAM. There we go, so it's just showing that it's better performing than the previous versions. Low power consumption, that's good. So, interesting. Anyway, if you're interested in the NVIDIA graphics card, it's the 4060 one. Here we go. I don't know what TI means. So here's a few specs. So, third generation ray tracing cores, fourth generation tensor cores. Okay. And then, of course, the CPU. Basically, it's 20 cores, 8 performance cores, 12 efficient cores, and 28 threads, because it's each of the performance cores can run 2 threads. The efficient cores only run 1 thread. There you go. Max turbo frequency, 5.4 gigahertz, and it's got 33 megabytes of cache. L2 cache is 28 megabytes. Very good. And it's new. It's just come out this year, in the first quarter of this year. So fairly new, fairly new. All right. And I might as well show you the listing on Amazon as well, huh? Now, I don't know what... this is the MSI ad for the thing. I don't know what actual motherboard it's got. So we'll figure that out when we have a look at it in a minute ourselves. So there you go. And this was the ad on on Amazon. As you can see, there was a whole bunch of options, and the one that I got was the i7-14th. I nearly bought the i5 13th. But it's amazingly expensive. Look at that. That's $2,500 nearly for the i5 13th. And you can get the i7 14th, which is better and newer, for $1,897. So it's like $500 cheaper, and it's better. So, yeah, if you're planning to buy a computer, just keep your eye out for that. Anyway, that's all to show you really about the specs. I'll put those links in the show notes for this video. Yeah, let's just pop back over to the lab. And we'll take this thing out of its box. Here we are in the lab. So this is the big box that's arrived today. I'm expecting a tower computer, and I think it comes with a keyboard and a mouse. Now, I don't need a keyboard and a mouse, so I'll be selling those on eBay. Now, how does this work? It's going to make me think. Maybe I can get in here, huh? Seem to be working. Now, okay. I'm not sure what this great big extra box is for. No, that's not going to work. How about if I put it this way? Alright. You know, I'm going to keep that bit of cardboard. If you haven't got yourself some Jackcat electric scissors, I'd certainly recommend them. Alright, can you see that? It says MSI Max Infinite S3 gaming laptop.
All right, well, I'm going to get this open. Just cardboard packaging. Good. All right, so what's in the box here? Tower, that's the side of it. Here's the keyboard. I'll have a look at that in a minute. I'm expecting a mouse as well, so I'm not sure what's in here. Yep, this is the mouse. Power cable. Wi-Fi antennas. Couple of stickers. It's like some SATA cables. Okay. Now, okay, well this is a side, so it might be optional, I'm not sure. Sort of translucent, hard to say. And then it's just this to go, I think. So we should be able to pop in and out. I'm just going to get rid of all this cardboard and I'll be back in a tick. All right, well, I got rid of that cardboard. So here is the computer. I'm going to pop it up on this bench here and we'll have a look on the inside. Two things to do. One is I want to figure out what kind of motherboard this has so I can get its specs. And the other thing to do is install the external power switch. So I'm not sure if I should install the power switch now and then try and pull it up and around later, or if I should put the power switch in and then install it when the computer's already underneath the bench. It's going under here, by the way, if I didn't already mention. It's going to go down there. Anyway, and we'll have a look at the stuff. I'll pop you over to the bench and we'll have a look in these little boxes here. So, let's have a look in, what are we going to do? We'll have a look in this first. So I'll pop you over to the camera. All right, well, here we are. This is my maths camera. I'm trying to set up in here so I can do my maths homework, which you can see at the back there. Now, we will, we might as well have a look at this here, why not? So, we did already have a quick look in here. This is the power cable. Very good. Two SATA cables. Okay, I don't think we'll be needing those. Got some Wi-Fi antennas, so there's no reason not to install those. We'll do that. This is the mouse. It's just a USB optical mouse, MSI brand. I'm going to be selling this. I wonder if it'll fit in here. It will. Great. Well, when I sell it, I'll ship it in this box. So it's very good. What's this? Some branding by the looks of it. Stickers and such. Oh no, it says that it's the PC guide. Okay. Let's have a look at that, huh? So there's some screws. There's some computer screws. I'm gonna need this. What's this? This product contains a button battery. Keep out of reach of children. Okay. So that's just a warning about the battery. Never seen that before. Okay. Showing you how to plug in your bits and pieces. Fair enough. Now, we're gonna need to label some of this stuff. Fairly robust looking cable. Now, alright, so there's our power cable. Now, this is the keyboard that it comes with. MSI, it's backlit, colourful. It's called the Vigor GK30. Just some ads and stuff on the back. So, just the old... I don't know what sort of switches it's got, does it say? I'm not seeing any specs on the switches. So, who knows? Anyway, I'm going to be selling this on eBay. If you want it, check it out. Now, what we've all been waiting for. Now, it seems to me that the side panel is optional. You can have either this one, which is see-through, or you can have this one, which is not. I'm not really sure exactly what I'd prefer. Let's see if we can get this open. Okay. Rust protection paper. So it's some sort of absorbent paper. Cool. Now, let's just pop this out of its bag. I'm having some trouble with the recording on the other computer, so I'm just going back to this view for a bit. Also, maybe I missed a little bit of the recording. I don't know. I think I recorded some footage and it didn't actually record. I'll figure all of that out later when I go to edit this video together. But for now, what I'm going to do, because unfortunately, the front panel connector here is all in one block, so I can't just put on just the bits that I want. So what I'm going to do is disconnect the front panel completely and then just put these in instead. So I pulled up a reference here. So let's see if I can figure that out. Alright, so the power LED. And the power switch. Now, just want to make sure that we get that. Okay. So positive seems to be on the far side there. All right, well, let's see how we go. And the other thing is, I'm going to need to feed it out. So I'll just try doing that out. Just feed them in this way. And this is the power switch, so it doesn't really matter which way it goes. Alright, so now we've got a LED hooked in, and we've got a power switch hooked in. There is no reset switch, there is no hard drive activity light. So hopefully I got that right. We'll have to plug it in and turn it on to know. And I'm going to wait to do that after it's all in. So fingers crossed that it works and I don't have to pull it all out again. I've got some thumb screws here. Put those in. Now I'm going to be upgrading the RAM on this, so I will have to pull it out again. So I might think about making a better cable that keeps the other buttons and such functional. We'll see. Anyway, that's that. I'm going to install this now, and I'll be back once that's done. So wish me luck. Here I go.
And that's a wrap. So my new computer is down there. It's all turned on and working. I've got my A10 4K DisplayPort KVM working, so I can switch between. I've got the headphones working. The onboard audio only had stereo. It didn't seem to have 5.1 surround sound, which I was expecting, so I obviously got my wires crossed there. But I've ordered a 5.1 surround sound USB adapter that should arrive from Amazon tomorrow. So when that gets here, I'll plug that in and I should be able to get surround sound for my games, which I'm hoping will work. But worst case, stereo headphones, good enough. I installed StarCraft 2 with Battle.net, and that worked. And I installed Doom 3 with Steam, and that worked. So I've got Steam operational, got Battle.net operational. I should be able to play all the games that I'm interested in, so that's pretty cool. The Windows properly supports the old 32-bit stuff as well. It's just backwards compatible, which is excellent. The Mac isn't, so I wasn't able to play Doom 3 on my new Mac, but I can play Doom 3 on my new Windows computer, which is called Treat. I presume you heard that already today. I managed to loop the power cable around, so that's pretty cool. I had to sacrifice my reset switch and my hard drive activity LED. I could fix that up, or maybe get another one of those buttons. We'll see. Anyway, that's not a big problem. So that's everything. That's mission accomplished for me. That's my new gaming rig. I'll put the specs in the show notes so you can check it out if you're interested. I'm pretty happy. Mission accomplished. So I've got a bunch of work to get on with for the next week or two, so you won't be hearing from me for a little while. I'll get some more videos out as soon as I can. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks very much for watching, and please remember to hit like and subscribe.